Greetings. This is part 5 of a series discussing John the Baptist, who Muhammad renamed Yahya. In part 4, we were going through the fascinating fantasy the Quran tells of Zechariah and Mary. But the idea that started me down this rabbit hole was Islam's counting John's father, named Zechariah, as a prophet of Islam. But there is already a real prophet of Israel named Zechariah. And the interesting implication of Islam thinking John's father is a prophet, Islam ignores and excludes the real prophet named Zechariah, including his message. Zechariah 1:1. In the 8th month of the 2nd year of the reign of Darius, the word of the Lord came to the prophet Zechariah, son of Berechiah, the son of Iddo, saying, So here we see Zechariah is identified as a prophet, and it gives his father's name, Berechiah. And this same man is referenced by Jesus the Messiah, who Islam strangely claims to respect as Messiah and a prophet. Matthew 23:1. Then Jesus spoke to the crowds and to his disciples. The scribes and Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. Jesus has a lot more to say, many woe to you judgments and warnings. I count 7. Finally, Jesus concludes his condemnation of the scribes and Pharisees. Verse 35, And so upon you will come all the righteous blood shed on earth, from the blood of righteous Abel to the blood of Zechariah, son of Berechiah, whom you murdered between the temple and the altar. Jesus calls out, by name and by his father's name, the prophet that Islam ignores. And I do not want to get too far off the track, but that is 4 big league prophetic hitters that Islam ignores as prophets. Isaiah, Malachi, Daniel, and Zechariah. So there is already a real prophet of Israel named Zechariah. He is a minor prophet who lived and was killed by the Jews. And as we have seen, Jesus himself referred to prophet Zechariah. Notice there was no mention that John's father was killed by the Jews. And so upon you will come all the righteous blood shed on earth, from the blood of righteous Abel to the blood of Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, whom you murdered between the temple and the altar. The book of Ezra also mentions a man named Zechariah. Now the prophets Haggai and Zechariah, son of Iddo, prophesied to the Jews who were in Judah and Jerusalem in the name of the God of Israel who was over them. Oh, so this is the son of Iddo and not the son of Berechiah that Jesus spoke of. And so upon you will come all the righteous blood shed on earth, from the blood of righteous Abel to the blood of Zechariah, son of Berechiah, whom you murdered between the temple and the altar. Ezra 6:14. And the elders of the Jews were successful in building through the prophesying of Haggai the prophet and Zechariah the son of Iddo, and they finished building according to the command of the God of Israel and the decree of Cyrus, Darius, and Artaxerxes, king of Persia. This is many hundreds of years before Jesus, John the Baptist, and his father Zechariah. But these references are to Zechariah, son of Iddo, and seemingly cannot be the prophet Zechariah who wrote the book of Zechariah. Right? Zechariah was a minor prophet, but still revealed significant details regarding the Messiah. Zechariah 9:9, Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion! Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem! Behold, your king is coming to you! Righteous and having salvation is he, humble and mounted on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. Matthew 21:5. Say to the daughter of Zion, See, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a beast of burden. John 12:14, finding a young donkey, Jesus sat on it, as it was written, "Do not be afraid, O daughter of Zion. See, your king is coming seated on a colt of a donkey." Zechariah 12:10, "Then I will pour out on the house of David and on the residents of Jerusalem a spirit of grace and prayer, and they will look on me, the one they have pierced. They will mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, and weep bitterly for him as one grieves a firstborn son." John 19:36, "Now these things happened so that the scripture would be fulfilled, not one of his bones will be broken." And as another scripture says, "They will look on the one they have pierced." So the book of Zechariah, written by prophet Zechariah, has a significant contribution to Messiah's story. And the author of the Quran is completely confused regarding the prophet named Zechariah. A mention of the mercy of your Lord to his servant Zechariah. And this will about sum up the Quran, a mere mention. But notice this calls Zechariah his, meaning Allah's, servant. Servant and messengers are synonyms in Islam for prophet. So you should understand, this text is the Quran speaking of a prophet. 19:3, "When he called upon his Lord in a low voice, in secrecy, in secret, privately, with a suppressed cry, inwardly." Those are all translations of the same word. "He said, 'My Lord, surely my bones are weakened and my head flares with hoariness, and my Lord, I have never been unsuccessful in my prayer to thee. And surely I fear my cousins after me, and my wife is barren, therefore grant me from thyself an heir.'" Remember from the last video, Zechariah prayed for a child in Mary's bedroom after seeing Mary have a food stash she said was from Allah. "Who should inherit me and inherit the children of Jacob and make him my Lord, one in whom thou art well pleased?" That Muhammad could spin a tale for sure. Now he's mentioned Jacob as well in Zechariah's imagined prayer. "O Zechariah, we bring thee glad tiding of a son whose name shall be John." Not Yahya, John. "Never have we given this name to anyone before him." So there was never anybody on earth named John. Or maybe just not given by Allah. Lots of Johns, but this is the first one Allah has called John. But clearly this is the Zechariah who was John's father, called a prophet. But no one on earth, beside the followers of Muhammad, who believe this story, think John's father was a prophet of Yahweh God. The Jews certainly do not believe Zechariah, the father of John, was a prophet. He did not author any text that was included in the prophets or the writings of the Tanakh. But to be perfectly clear, this Zechariah was a priest, and at times he was filled by the Holy Spirit, and he did prophesy over his son John. But this Zechariah was not considered a prophet, and certainly not the author of the book of Zechariah. Which means one other error. Islam ignores the actual prophet Zechariah who authored the book of Zechariah. There is also other mention of this Zechariah in the Quran, retelling the story yet again. Because if you repeat a lie often enough, some people will begin to accept it as true. And eventually, 1.5 billion people may believe it is true. So there seem to be three men named Zechariah mentioned in the Bible. Zechariah the prophet, son of Berechiah, Zechariah son of Iddo, Zechariah priest, father of prophet John the Baptist. But wait, are there really three separate men? Zechariah 1:1. "In the eighth month of the second year of Darius, the word of the Lord came to the prophet Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, son of Iddo, saying," Zechariah cannot be the son of two men. One translation clears it up, indicating Berechiah was the son of Iddo. Zechariah is actually the grandson of Iddo. So it looks more like there are only two men mentioned in the Bible named Zechariah. And the author of the Quran badly conflates and confuses the two. One would have to consider that an Allah who sent a prophet might reasonably know that prophet. But the stories in the Quran about Zechariah, the servant of Allah, or prophet, only speaks of praying for a baby and getting told by angels about John. Quran 21:89. Remember Zechariah when he called out to his Lord, "Do not leave me heirless, Lord. You are the best of heirs." So we heard his prayer and bestowed John upon him, and made his wife fit to bear him a child. They used to hasten to do good, and they called on us in hope and fear, and they were always humble toward us. Let's go back one ayat. Remember Zechariah, when he called out to his Lord, "Do not leave me heirless, Lord. You are the best of heirs." You are the best of heirs? What does that even mean? But I'm sure in 1400 years, Islam has invented some very creative prose to explain this for Allah. I could only find one other reference to Zechariah in the Quran. Quran 685. Zechariah, John, Jesus, and Elijah, every one of them was righteous. And perhaps you can see how an uneducated man became confused in his thinking, claiming the father of John, Zechariah, was somehow a related prophet. Kind of like Star Wars. "The Force was strong in the house of Imran." Now, some Muslims might try and claim the two men are not confused, that only John's father was the real prophet of Allah. I have not heard that specific claim, but the confusion is readily evident. I briefly searched the web looking for Islamic websites and their story about Zechariah. Thoughtco.com. Sounds like a thinking website, right? No, it's Islamic. Zechariah, or Zechariah, was the father of John the Baptist, the guardian of Issa's mother Mary, and a righteous priest who lost his life for his faith. There is no record in the Bible that John's father was killed for his faith. But Prophet Zechariah certainly was. This is the mixing, the confusion of the men and their stories. www.islamweb.net. That sounds authoritative. Nonetheless, the books of Tafsir, interpretation of the Quran, stated that the Prophet Zechariah and Yahya or John, may Allah exalt their mention, were killed by the Jews. Remember, Islam's Zachary or Zechariah is John's father. Islam is completely ignorant of the reality there were two men named Zechariah, one a prophet, one a priest. Of course, there have been many men through history named Zechariah, but we are speaking of those mentioned in the Bible, which Islam steals and corrupts. One additional tragedy of the errors in the Quran is they are empty, void, containing not one useful detail. What did Zechariah say or do or perform or bring as a prophet of Allah? He saw Mary with lots of food and was inspired to pray for a child. And that is the end of the Quranic content which Zechariah allegedly contributed? Think about that. Islam has managed to keep the name Zechariah associated with a prophet, but completely castrate him of any spiritual message. On top of that, Islam deletes the actual message which Zechariah, the father of John, prophesied over his son. Satan's web of errors and falsehoods must be respected for the effectiveness of its deception. And Muslims for 1400 years have said they respect Prophet Zechariah, an empty husk of a name alone. If you are Christian, please try to have sympathy and love for Muslims who sincerely accept Satan's fraud. Pray for them that their eyes might be opened to hear details of the world outside Muhammad's prison of darkness. By the Holy Spirit of Yahweh God, Zechariah the priest, the father of John, identified John as the first prophet of Malachi 3:1. This was revelation from Yahweh God, but that did not make Zechariah a prophet. It certainly did not make him the prophet who authored the book of Zechariah. This confusion for Muslims arises because they have no concept of the Holy Spirit of God, the third precious member of the Trinity. But that is a topic for a different video series. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.